your right has been violated by state or non-state actors, the Uganda Human Rights Commission is open and it will continuously receive your complaints, and we shall investigate and compensate you and even bring the culprits to book. No one is above the law, so we shall have to deal with everyone who violates the other's rights.
A Uganda Human Rights Commission tribunal presided over by Commissioner Shifra Lukwago heard 7 cases and made 13 decisions on Friday in Jinja. Vincent Waibi's case was handled first. He lost his son, James Besesira, in 2014 after he was mistreated and tortured in the hands of police officers. He died in cells at Ndolwa Police Post in Buyende District.
After his death, denied his father, his son, and fatherhood to his children. Your son had kids, right? Including the year when the above case precept was decided because the value of the money had not yet been spent. I therefore award the estate of the victim, Baliasirira James, a total sum of 14 million as general damages and exemplary damages of 500,000 shillings for the violation of victim's right.
While delivering her decision, Commissioner Lukwago awarded Waibi 40.5 million shillings for the loss of his son. Waibi commended the Uganda Human Rights Commission Tribunal for delivering the long overdue justice.
So, woman rights echoes the kinning in
Charles Ogwal, a resident in Jinja City, was arrested and tortured in police cells at Jinja Central Police Station on allegations that he murdered his wife. The commission awarded Ogwal 9.3 million shillings, but he wasn't satisfied with the decision and vowed to appeal.
They decided to compensate us, but for me, how they compensate us, it is not right, because torture, and somebody spoiling your name, and putting you for 1 month and 2 weeks, then they give you a little money like this. Yeah, I'm not actually happy about it. I want to make an appeal.
Betty Nangoli, the regional manager of Uganda Human Rights Commission in Jinja, says they will provide support to the beneficiaries in pursuit of their pay.
Write letters to the registrar who sits in head office in the Directorate of Complaints, Investigations and Legal Services. It's manned by the Director of Complaints and Investigations. So we'll write an introduction letter to our head office, and that introduction letter usually contains the decision that was made, and it contains the particulars of the complainant. So when we write that letter, they go with that letter to head office, and then our head office team takes over from there. There is also a letter there.
Many more others who received justice commended the Uganda Human Rights Commission but lamented about the long wait. This report was compiled by Ivan Lubega for the news.